right, as we look into God's word today, I want you guys to keep thinking about this. Do you believe that what you believe is really real? All of us believe certain things, like gravity exists. We're all sitting here, we all believe that if I throw something at you, it will hit the ground. So why don't we take this same action in our beliefs when it comes to our relationship with Jesus Christ? The part of this relationship that I'm going to be talking to you guys about today is how we are united with Christ. And in Romans 6, verses 4 and 5, it says, "We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. If we have been united with him like this in his death, we will certainly also be united with him in his resurrection." As Christians, when Christ died on the cross, he took our sin. So when we accept him, we are united with him in his death. So just as he was raised from the dead on the third day, we are also raised in a new being. We're a new creation. We don't have to walk in sin anymore, and we have the Spirit in us as a new being. In Galatians 2:1, it says, "I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ is in me. The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me." So that just as it says in Romans, we are a new creature, we're a new creation. Later in Romans 6, it talks about how after we accept Christ, after we become that new creature, we're now an instrument for righteousness. It says to no longer live in sin and be that instrument for unrighteousness, but to live and be dead to sin and to be an instrument for God. And in this verse, the way it's translated, that word instrument also is used as a word that means weapon. So we are to be a weapon for Christ. And just like when, say, I was going to go hunting and take my gun with me, the gun, in this sense, would be like me, would be the Christian, be the weapon. The hunter would be my Heavenly Father, and in order for the gun to be useful, it has to be united or with the hunter. And a gun in the hand of a hunter is a weapon being used for the right purpose. If that same gun was in the hand of a criminal, or say the hand of Satan and was in sin, then it would be the instrument for unrighteousness. For me, I haven't been an effective weapon for my Heavenly Father, for the weapon he's been living through my life, because I've been terrified, utterly and completely terrified, to share what has been going on in my life and the struggles I've been through and the things I've been having a really hard time with, because I was scared of being rejected. And until I came to this realization that I was united with my Heavenly Father and that through him I have the strength and the ability to be that weapon without being scared, I was completely ineffective. I was like that gun in the hand of a criminal. So I want you guys to ask yourselves, do I believe that what I believe is really real? What actions am I taking, like standing here and believing that gravity is going to hold me down? What actions can I take every day that will be just as effective in my belief to show the world to be that weapon for me?